Hello guys and girls, in this video I'm gonna show you how I efficiently make Anki cards. Being a medical student, our time to study is very limited and the time you spend making Anki cards can significantly reduce your time to study. Of course, making the cards or the notes can be considered as a form of study, but I want to spend more time doing Anki cards than making them. The first thing you need to do is start getting used to the keyboard shortcuts. Note that I'm also using cloze deletions card type. This note type is way more useful than the basic note type or any other note type for that matter. And you can make a much greater number of cards within a given amount of time than any other note type. If you were to use the basic card type, you would have to take the facts from your note and then word it differently and type it by yourself in the Anki notes to make a front and back card. But if you are using cloze deletions, all you have to do is copy the text from your lecture note and then paste it in the Anki note. And then choose the keywords in that sentence or paragraph and turn them into blanks by making a cloze deletion. You can even choose to show the blanks on the same card or even on different cards. This way, you'll be able to make several number of cards from one note, and that will amount to a greater number of cards in a given time than when you're making basic cards. When you're making cloze deletions, you might be tempted to copy big paragraphs and paste it onto your note and make a large number of cards. This method is not so effective, as you will have to read that entire paragraph every time you do a card. Try to keep your notes with a maximum of around 10 to 15 words and a maximum of 4 cards per note. It is also important that you have read and understood the lecture before you make Anki cards from that. This will allow you to know exactly which keywords and facts should be highlighted, underlined, and closed. You can use the PowerPoints or PDFs of the lecture handouts from your faculty, or you can even use the PDFs of the textbooks that are prescribed by your faculty or school. You can even use reliable websites or anything really that you can copy and paste to your note from. However, if you are using some note that you usually don't, for example, a website or an internet article, it is better that you mention the source in the extras box of the note when you're making the Anki note. I'm using a few add-ons to help me make cards more efficiently. For example, the frozen fields add-on helps me keep the extras or the text from my previous card, so I wouldn't have to copy and paste the same thing over and over again if I'm making similar cards. If you can add an image to your extras, for example, if you are making a note in a subject like anatomy, it is more important to have a visual input. You have to find a relevant image from Google Images or your lecture note and press Windows Shift S and then drag to fit the image. The image will be copied to your clipboard and you can simply just paste it in your Anki note. Another note type that I'm using is the Image Occlusion Enhanced. It is a separate add-on that you have to get, but it allows you to make notes directly from pictures by occluding certain parts of the picture, for example labels. This method is very useful when you have to remember to draw or label diagrams. I will leave a link in the description for all the add-ons I'm using to make cards. Alright everyone, thanks for watching and make sure to hit the like button and subscribe.